복사기가 고장 난 것 같아요. How do we say this in English? Kevin이 도와줄 수 있을 거예요. 이런 문제는 Kevin이 전문가죠. Kevin can help. He's the go-to person for those things. Kevin? 그 프로그래머? The computer programmer? All right, let's look at the entire dialogue. Okay, at the office, something breaks down. We have the computer. We have the copier. 뭐 거의 다 모든 사무실들이 다 있는 거죠. 아니면은 뭐 커피 머신도 고장이 날 수 있어요. So, 아 고장이 날다 생각할 때는 뭐 broken 혹시 그렇게 생각하실까요? All right. So, let's see what we have here. Something's wrong with the copier. Something's wrong with the copier. 자, 복사기가 고장 난 것 같아요. 여기서는 broken이 없네요. Yes. Well, of course, it's broken. Broken이라는 건 사실 완전 망가진 거예요. 그래서 뭔가 문제가 있다. 뭔가 이렇게 난 정확히 모르겠는데 이게 작동이 잘 제대로 안 된다. 그럴 때는 사실 something's wrong with 이런 표현도 참 좋습니다. Alright? Something's wrong with the copier. I don't know what it is, but something's not right. Okay, something's wrong with the copier. Kevin can help. He's the go-to person for those things. Kevin can help. He's the go-to person for those things. 자, very easy, right? Kevin can help. 얼마나 간단해요. Kevin이 도와줄 수 있어요. He can help you with that. 그런 것보다 he can help, all right? He's the go-to person for those things. 자, 이런 문제는 Kevin이 전문가예요. 전문가 할 때 뭐 expert, 뭐 professional 이런 단어가 생각이 나죠. But in this case, we decided to use go-to person. 사실 이거를 굉장히 많이 쓰거든요. Go-to person. Go-to person은 거기에 뭔가 이렇게 go-to 뭔가 문제 있으면 그 사람한테 가는 거예요. okay? So, 문제가 있어? 그러면 go-to person이 Kristen이에요. 그러면 Kristen한테 가는 거예요. Alright? So, that's why it's the go-to person. Go-to Kristen. Okay. So, go-to person is the person who knows how to solve the problem or who has a lot of knowledge, 지식. About this situation, okay? So, Kevin can help. He's the go-to person for those things. 그런 문제들이 있을 때는 Kevin이 잘 도와드릴 거야, okay? Kevin, the computer programmer. Kevin, the computer programmer. 자, 이제 직장 시작한 지가 많이 오래되지 않아서 좀 누가 누군지를 잘 몰라서 Kevin, 아, 그 프로그래머? 네, 그렇게 이제 확인하는 거죠. All right, let's look at the dialogue one more time. Something's wrong with the copier. Kevin can help. He's the go-to person for those things. Kevin, the computer programmer? Okay. All right, let's look at some key points. Something is wrong with. Okay. Now, it's interesting. 뭔가 고장이 나다, 아니면 문제가 생기다, 아니면 뭔가 잘못됐다, 아니면은 뭔가 좀 이상하다. 사람에도 쓸 수도 있습니다. 그러니까, 아, 뭔가 조금 이상해. 뭔가 조금 이렇게, 뭔가 조금 문제가 있는 것 같아. So, in this case, something is wrong with Kristen. She seems upset. Something is wrong with Kristen. She seems upset. 여기는 문제죠. 아, 뭔가 Kristen이 무슨 문제가 생길 것 같아. 속상해 보이는데. Right. So, when you don't know what the problem is, but you know something is not right, this is how you would use this expression. Something's wrong with Kristen or something's wrong with the boss. 팀장님이 좀 뭔가 좀 이상해. 문제 있는 것 같아. Something's wrong with the boss. Okay. So you can use this on people. How about the next one? Something is wrong with the report. Aha. The numbers seem inaccurate. Something is wrong with the report. The numbers seem inaccurate. 자, 보고서가 잘못된 것 같아. 숫자가 틀렸어. 아, so 뭔가 정확히 뭔지는 모르겠지만 문제는 뭔가 좀 이상해요. 뭔가 문제가 있어요. So something 보고서가 좀 문제가 있어. The numbers seem inaccurate. So accurate는 뭐 이렇게 정확하지 않고 좀 틀린 거죠. Right? When something is accurate, we know it's to be true. But here in this case, it's a little wrong. All right. Something is wrong with the report. The numbers seem inaccurate. All right, let's move on to the next one. Go to person. Remember, go to person? You go to that person, okay? 전문가죠. All right. John is the go-to person for computer problems. John is the go-to person for computer problems. 자, 존은 컴퓨터 문제 전문가다. Okay, so, go-to person for 뭐뭐 computer problems, for writing, for editing, 뭐 다양 전문적인 게 있죠. So it really depends on that person. How about the next example? Julie is the go-to person for advice. Julie is the go-to person for advice. 자, 줄리는 조언 전문가다. So if you have a problem, you should talk to Julie. She is very, okay, 상담하기 좋은 Julie죠. All right, so go-to person, Kristen is the go-to teacher for business English. Okay, so 전문가, the person that you want to see, the person who's very good at what they do. All right, let's move on to shadowing.